Test 4. Listening Part 4. You will hear an interview with a woman called Natasha Green, who is talking about her job as an archaeologist. For questions 24 to 30, choose the best answer, A, B, or C. You now have 1 minute to look at Part 4.
Today I'm talking to Natasha Green, who's an archaeologist. Welcome, Natasha. Could I start by asking what made you want to be an archaeologist?
I was interested in the dinosaur remains that were being dug up in Australia when I was growing up there, though none of them were discovered near where I lived. But my aunt and uncle, who loved the outdoors, took me on a camping trip, and I came across a stone tool that looked fascinating. It turned out to be 80,000 years old, and archaeologists got really excited about it because it suggested people had been in Australia longer than previously thought. From that day on, there was only one career for me.
You have a special interest in the archaeology of the Sahara Desert. What's it like digging there?
It's not everyone's dream to spend the summer vacation working in the baking sun in temperatures of over 40 degrees. My friends think I'm mad, but I love the desert. There are places where you can dig almost anywhere and be guaranteed of finding something. Sometimes it drives me mad because I just don't know where to investigate next. But I find the desert beautiful, especially at night time when it's cooler and so quiet.
What kind of preparation goes into a new dig? Presumably you want to know whether another archaeologist has already dug there before.
Well, that doesn't require too much effort to find out. There are written records for digs going back over 100 years. When I'm on a project and someone digs something up out of the ground, it's important that I can immediately identify what it is. That way the other archaeologists assisting me know what to do with the object, how to process it, as we say, in order to keep it in the best possible condition.
So, what particular skills would you say an archaeologist needs?
I don't imagine anyone would be surprised to hear me say IT knowledge is vital, as that's the case in most research-type jobs. What's less widely known is that we still produce drawings of every site as a way to record where we find the objects. If you're on a dig, you have to be able to take your turn at doing that. Depending where your archaeological project is taking place in the world, you may need to be able to speak a foreign language, but I suppose that's self-evident, really.
Can children get involved in archaeology?
Absolutely. It's a great way for even very young children to start learning about the past. Even if you don't have archaeological sites near you, all libraries have archaeology books for youngsters. There are also lots of websites on the subject for kids too. I'd encourage anyone, young or old, to learn all about this fascinating subject. Maybe there's a dig in your area you could go and see, but health and safety regulations mean they couldn't let you join in just like that.
What should people do if they find something in the ground that looks very old?
Well, not just keep it for themselves, definitely. Objects from the past are part of our shared culture, so they need to be examined carefully by a specialist and put on display for the public to see. It makes me furious to hear stories of people not taking things they find to a museum.
Do you think there'll be less need for archaeologists in the future? After all, so much about the past is already known.
There are layers and layers of the past beneath our feet that haven't yet been discovered. Every city construction site has to be investigated by archaeologists to see what ancient remains are there, and that'll carry on. Remains that are open to the public are exposed to weather and pollution. This means we're going to have to devote more effort to making sure they stay in the best possible condition to preserve them for future generations.
Natasha, thanks. And later on in the show...
Now you will hear part four again.
Today I'm talking to Natasha Green, who's an archaeologist. Welcome, Natasha. Could I start by asking what made you want to be an archaeologist?
I was interested in the dinosaur remains that were being dug up in Australia when I was growing up there, though none of them were discovered near where I lived. But my aunt and uncle, who loved the outdoors, took me on a camping trip, and I came across a stone tool that looked fascinating. It turned out to be 80,000 years old, and archaeologists got really excited about it because it suggested people had been in Australia longer than previously thought. From that day on, there was only one career for me.
You have a special interest in the archaeology of the Sahara Desert. What's it like digging there?
It's not everyone's dream to spend the summer vacation working in the baking sun in temperatures of over 40 degrees. My friends think I'm mad, but I love the desert. There are places where you can dig almost anywhere and be guaranteed of finding something. Sometimes it drives me mad because I just don't know where to investigate next. But I find the desert beautiful, especially at night time when it's cooler and so quiet.
What kind of preparation goes into a new dig? Presumably you want to know whether another archaeologist has already dug there before.
Well, that doesn't require too much effort to find out. There are written records for digs going back over 100 years. When I'm on a project and someone digs something up out of the ground, it's important that I can immediately identify what it is. That way the other archaeologists assisting me know what to do with the object, how to process it, as we say, in order to keep it in the best possible condition.
So, what particular skills would you say an archaeologist needs?
I don't imagine anyone would be surprised to hear me say IT knowledge is vital, as that's the case in most research-type jobs. What's less widely known is that we still produce drawings of every site as a way to record where we find the objects. If you're on a dig, you have to be able to take your turn at doing that. Depending where your archaeological project is taking place in the world, you may need to be able to speak a foreign language, but I suppose that's self-evident, really.
Can children get involved in archaeology?
Absolutely. It's a great way for even very young children to start learning about the past. Even if you don't have archaeological sites near you, all libraries have archaeology books for youngsters. There are also lots of websites on the subject for kids too. I'd encourage anyone, young or old, to learn all about this fascinating subject. Maybe there's a dig in your area you could go and see, but health and safety regulations mean they couldn't let you join in just like that.
What should people do if they find something in the ground that looks very old?
Well, not just keep it for themselves, definitely. Objects from the past are part of our shared culture, so they need to be examined carefully by a specialist and put on display for the public to see. It makes me furious to hear stories of people not taking things they find to a museum.
Do you think there'll be less need for archaeologists in the future? After all, so much about the past is already known.
There are layers and layers of the past beneath our feet that haven't yet been discovered. Every city construction site has to be investigated by archaeologists to see what ancient remains are there, and that'll carry on. Remains that are open to the public are exposed to weather and pollution. This means we're going to have to devote more effort to making sure they stay in the best possible condition to preserve them for future generations.
Natasha, thanks. And later on in the show...
That is the end of part four. There will now be a pause of 5 minutes for you to copy your answers onto the separate answer sheet. Be sure to follow the numbering of all the questions. I will remind you when there is 1 minute left, so that you are sure to finish in time. You have 1 more minute left. That is the end of the test. Please stop now. Your supervisor will now collect all the question papers and answer sheets.